So hi, hello and welcome again. Microbehunter here. Well, what you see here on the computer monitor behind me, that is the cross section of the leaf of a fern plant. And it's live from a microscope here. And today I'm going to put a fern under the microscope. Yeah, but that's not the only thing. I really want to answer one question. And it is, how do fern actually reproduce? And how are they able to reproduce without seeds? Because many plants have seeds, but not ferns. So how does this actually work? And I have to tell you, it's a pretty complicated life cycle. It started off the whole story a couple of weeks ago when I visited the forest. My kids were playing in the forest, rolling those balls around and down the hill and playing around. And I was waiting there and I saw a fern standing next to me, growing next to me. And immediately, I had to, of course, touch it and turn it around. And on the bottom side of the fern, on the bottom side of these leaves, I saw those tiny little dots, and these are the so-called the sporangia. These are the reproductive structures of a fern. And when I saw that, well, then of course I had to think back a long time ago at university when I was studying in the first semester. I was studying botany. Look what I brought along here. I found the book that I had to study. That's the book. Look, this is a scary book. It's botany, the introduction to botany. Not only introduction, it's also pretty advanced already. And it also contains a lot of information about, not only fern, but also other types of plants. And I had to study this stuff here. And kind of when I saw the fern plant in the forest, I had to think of the botany course that I took right at the beginning of my studies long time ago. It's a pretty heavy book. It was also a pretty scary lecture that I had to attend there because it was quite advanced. A fern, when you put it under the microscope, and this is what I have done, I've taken along a small leaf from the fern and I tapped the leaf at home on a microscope slide with a little bit of water to wash out the spores, because actually fern reproduce by spores, but not only, right? So what you see here in the backside, this is the so-called sporangium, which produces those spores. And these sporangia that produce the spores, they can be found on the bottom side of the leaf of the fern. And essentially what happens is that those spores, they are scattered, they fall to the ground, and they start to germinate and they start to grow, and they start to form a very tiny fern plant that's less than a centimeter across, quite small. Usually they start to grow right next to the fern plant because this is where the spores fall down, right? But they don't get much larger. But what they do grow is those small fern plants, which don't look like a fern, they have a heart shape, kind of like a leaf. They form sperm and eggs. And those sperm and eggs, they of course fertilize, and then when you have fertilization happening, you have got a fertilized egg cell, it starts to divide again, and then out of this tiny plant grows a big plant, again a new fern plant, and then this big fern plant produces again those spores. So what you have is you have this alternation of generations. You have the big plant called the sporophyte generation, that's the big fern plant that we see here. It's called sporophyte because it produces the spores. Then the spores, they form the small gametophyte because it produces the sperm and the eggs. These are called the gametes. That's why it's called gametophyte. And then you have a sporophyte and a gametophyte and a sporophyte. So you call this an alternation of generations, but there are no seeds there, right? So essentially it's a completely different life cycle, and all of this stuff here is explained in this book. And when I saw the fern growing in the forest, I had to immediately think of the stuff that I had to study a long time ago. And then when I pulled out the book from my library, I haven't opened it for many years, and I realized, of course, look, the name of one of these authors here, Friedrich Ehrendorfer. He was actually a very famous, or not famous, maybe a very renowned or well-known botanist at the University of Vienna, where I studied. He already passed away several years ago. He was one of my professors. He was super, super competent. I mean, he knew, of course, a lot about botany. And I remember one of the excursions that he took us along. Over 30 years ago on the botanical excursion. Very, very interesting. That's a little bit the legacy that I've kept right now. So every time when I go into the forest, I have to think a little bit about the time long gone, when basically I had to study this material. I mean, there's a little bit of nostalgia right now with that, but I have to tell you, this exam here that I had to study for was absolutely difficult. It was one of those selective exams to reduce the number of students. So there have been cases where around 80% of the students who took this exam failed. I was lucky. I passed right there. I was really happy. I did not do very well, I have to admit. But considering the fact that around 80% of the students failed the exam, I was quite happy with the result. But that's basically what's left over. So I'm now, I can share this knowledge that I've gained long time ago with you now. And now you know that fern reproduce over, over spores, among other things. I'm just going to leave it at that. I wish you all the best. Happy microbe hunting as always. And see you in the next video. Bye-bye.